much for coming to a concert that is, you know, after the school year. So it's really nice to have people here. And we're going to start with a scherzo, which is a very transparent, fun little romp. And I think that's all we really need to say about it.
Thank you.
going on to the more serious top part of our program. We're having the Chamber Ensemble will be doing the last moment of the Hope for Symphony. We'll have a slight scene change here. The Shostakovich Second Piano Concerto is the, I think, Opus 67. It was written, I believe, in the middle of the siege of Leningrad. This was during the Second World War. The conductor of the Leningrad Philharmonic had been evacuated to Siberia along with the rest of the Leningrad Philharmonic. And Shostakovich and his family eventually were evacuated to, around Moscow. So at this point, Leningrad was being starved out by the Nazis in the hope that the city would fall. It took 3 years for the siege to end. Many people died. Many people were determined. In fact, the Seventh Symphony of Shostakovich, he wrote, he finished, and wanted this orchestra, the Leningrad Phil, to play, and they were, I believe that they were at this point evacuated. And so there were some musicians still left in the city from the radio orchestras, and there were something like 15 people left who had not starved, and they came and performed the Seventh Symphony in Leningrad as Shostakovich wanted. They had to get the military band players to come in to fill in because the musicians were so weak, and I think three of them died during rehearsals. And they were given rations, food rations, to try to keep their strength up. But they were so determined to play it. Now, this trio was written a little later, but it's dedicated to that conductor who was Jewish, and he died in Siberia during the siege. And he was one of Shostakovich's dearest friends. And so there are Yiddish folk tunes throughout in the first movement and in the last movement, particularly the middle movements. There's a kind of frenetic scherzo, and then there is a very serene slow movement, which is also kind of maybe a funeral barge going down the river. In the last movement, what you need to know about these tunes is that Shostakovich was thinking about the Jewish people who had been forced to dance by their graves that they had dug themselves. So it's a fairly profound piece. It seems appropriate in this time and at this time of year as well. It can make us thankful for what we have and thoughtful of those we don't have. Sussex Carol, I think you'll recognize. And they're all kind of bound together. How many of you remember Polar Express? How many of you remember the book? The movie's just as good.
Thank you.
conductor asks you to stand and you're trying to turn pages. But, you know, the applause is for them. So, this is your turn if you want. We don't have any words in the program, but if you know the French for bring a torch, Jeanette and Isabella, sing along. And you all can wassail too.